Welcome to New Week Monday. Didn't film myself at work typing or editing or cursing the computer when it was doing the beach ball of doom. I restarted my computer 7 times today. I think the video cache is chock full. Anyway, filming the fun stuff here at Oaks with Boyd, the king of waterfall. So I'm gonna try not to kill myself here. I got 6 more days. Here at the top, this is Matt Boyd, one of the cast of characters I ride with, one of the Whistler crew. So everyone kind of knows Emter's deal, but like, what? I met you riding motocross.
Yeah.
Years ago, you had a YZ250. Why did you stop dirt bikes and how'd you pick up mountain bikes?
Well, I got tired of seeing all my friends get hurt, for one.
Who got hurt? I never
Present
got hurt.
Company included.
Oh. Okay.
It just became a hassle getting to the track. You know, if they built something in Orange County, I'd probably get back into it. And then my friend Scott Nakamura introduced me to mountain biking and said, hey, we go to this place called Whistler. You should buy a bike and come with us. So I bought a bike, rode a couple of local trails, and went to Whistler.
Straight to Whistler?
Straight to Whistler.
Oh, Jesus.
12 years later, still going.
Yeah. So do you get the same scratching of the itch on a mountain bike?
Not as much. Not as, it's not, the scratch isn't as satisfying, but yeah. It's pretty good. Pretty good.
I think for me, it's still so new, I like it better than motocross.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I love dirt bikes, for sure, but it's my job too, you know?
Yeah. I do miss dirt bikes, but yeah, if you go to the right trails, you can scratch the itch.
Whistler, especially.
Yeah.
So what do you do during the week?
For work?
Yeah.
I work for a cancer testing lab. We get all the cancer specimens from local hospitals and do cancer testing.
Hmm.
It's not super exciting. It can be a little depressing, but...
Do you like when everything comes out negative?
Helping people out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
And do you agree with me that it's been a boring summer without Emter?
Absolutely. Gotta get him healed up.
He's always the guy that can go.
Yeah.
He's down for anything. We'll go anywhere.
I mean, we went through Fester Canyon the other day, and it just wasn't the same without him. It was not Fester Canyon without him. So, yeah, it's a bummer. Got to get well, Steve.
Okay, so Oaks is your backyard.
Yeah, I can ride here from my house.
That's why you're so fast down waterfall.
But I usually get lazy and drive to the trailhead anyway. But yeah, it's not the best trails, but it's close.
That's good. Convenient.
It works. It's good climbing training.
Mm. Oh, this is it. Yeah, cheater. I've crashed there so many times. Like I almost did right now. Oh, fuck. Fuck, another cheater on me. Dude, I caught several lines from you. This is Matt's frame breaker. Thank you. Well, the funny thing about Oaks is it's only 6 3/8 miles, and it feels like you did 10. But anytime you finish at Oaks without crashing, it's a win for me.
Good day.
A lot of potential eat shits out there for me. All right, we're at the LA. Huh? Oh, Chase is doing a news break today.
Oh, is he?
Dude.
Oh. Yeah,
so stoked.
Oh, man. Hey, wait, hold on. You're going to be like right in front of a camera at a desk, and you're going to do like the whole like.
Yeah.
Do the whole Anton deal.
He is.
Anton video.
It's Chase's take. Because like you saw my take with Marvin in my suit.
Yeah.
All right, so we're at the LA Coliseum for the Super Motocross press conference. We got Chase, Stapo, Knobby Shop International, A-Ray in his O'Neill shirt.
Oh, look at that.
O'Neill HJC.
Yeah, enjoying the ride.
Yeah. We're enjoying the ride. Frankie.
Yep.
What do you think about that statue up there, dude?
Yeah, it's missing some heads.
Huh? How come all the statues I saw in Italy, all the dicks are broken off? You know?
I see the head.
No, no, no. There's
a head.
I went to Italy last week.
Oh, there's a vagina and a dick head.
I went to Italy, and I went to like the Vatican Museum and stuff. All the statues, those white statues, the dick's broken off.
Yeah, because people wanted to use it.
You take
for
the
themselves.
Dick. But the dick's on that
so
one.
They stole it.
Huh? They stole the dick?
Yeah.
I thought that's where the term broke dick came from, maybe.
Like, not out
here. Oh, here's this guy.
Because you have that problem?
Huh? Me?
Broken one?
No, I don't have a broke dick. You know, Mike at Roy's has a broke dick.
Well, I don't know. I never seen it.
He crashed at Skyline and hit his dick on a sign. And he says it doesn't work anymore.
Are you serious?
Serious, yeah. My poor wife, huh? Oh, shit. Wait. Look at these new clothes.
Okay. Hi.
You look good in black.
Black and yellow.
Black and yellow?
It's going to take some time to get used to still.
Yeah.
You're getting yelled at.
How can you help me?
Yes.
You got to check in, Don.
Where do I check in?
It's media.
Oh, okay. Come over here, sir.
Check over here?
Check in my face.
I like your makeup.
Oh, thank you. Oh, my God.
Hey boy, you got a gift bag. What's in the gift bag?
Yeah, what
we
do we got here?
All kinds of super motocross swag. We have Yetis. We have two different size Yetis.
Oh shit,
we have
Yetis.
Flat bills, and we have snapbacks, and we have baseball caps, golf towels, stickers.
So based on how I look, do I get the snapback or the flat bill?
Snapback. Here you go, you're a snapback guy.
We'll trade you.
Yeah.
All right, cool. We'll save that
and
one for my
guys. You need a swag bag too.
Oh.
Here you go. And
can I have that kind of hat?
Yeah, sure.
I think Don would definitely look good in that hat you were trying to give him.
Huh? The bro hat?
The bro hat.
What size shirt would you like?
Let's do a large.
Large?
Okay. Yes. I got one for Sam too.
Did you?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah, they're more for here. Here's a large.
All right, thank you very much. We're taking a prom picture. Let's do it like prom.
Do you want me to hold you in your arms?
Like
holding hands?
Huh? Yeah, like this.
Like me holding your ass?
Huh? Yeah, no, I like holding hands.
Oh, okay.
Like a prom photo.
Alright.
How's it going, gentlemen?
How are we doing?
Right. Day in paradise.
What is this for?
There's nice little souvenir photos. As you can see, it has a little background for you. And then you guys can take it home, share it to social media.
Hey, that's
You got to stand right here
fancy.
On the green screen.
Alright.
That
was our prom photo.
You know,
that's
our photo?
Huh?
That's cute.
Come on, let's see what you guys got. Hey, put your hand on his stomach like when people are pregnant.
There you go. Ready? The camera's right here. The count of three. One, two, and three. Hold it.
Hey, it's
shrinking.
Oh, it's we made
shrinking. It. I got it. Let's see if we got it.
It's shrinking.
We got it. Perfect.
Just
yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah, no, good job.
Hey, perfect.
Hey.
Are you guys going to do a prom photo?
Yeah.
You and Marv?
With our
Yetis. Oh, I got a Yeti too, huh? Those
Super
are cool.
World Motocross.
Which one you got, though? No. There's two models.
Oh, I don't know.
He's got the 125.
I got the 125, the little one. They gave me the Asian one, you know?
How's it going, gentlemen?
How are we doing?
Great, great. You guys want to take individual photos or like a big group photo?
No, we'll do a group.
Let's do it. All right, let's get you all in there. Squeeze in there. Pretend you guys like each other. She actually met this morning. So
I love it.
There you go. Makes you guys should carry maps.
All right, so nice big smiles. Look right here at the camera on a count of three. One, two, and three. Perfect. Let me just make sure the hat got in there. All right, let's try it one more time. One more time.
Oh.
We got to readjust.
All right, and then guys, ready? Camera's right here on a count of three. One, two, and three. Perfect.
That was like a four.
Who's gonna?
I got a t-shirt, a hat, and a Yeti. Like Yeti. a Yeti coffee cup.
I'm almost stoked about my Yeti. All right.
I got the small one. Though.
Yeah. Oh, I got a big one.
Oh, the hat's cool. It's a 950. They should have added R. What do you think? Supermotocross.
Motocross?
Yeah. Ulrich, what happened to your head, dude?
It's a great story.
Huh?
It's not a great story.
Mountain biking?
No, I wish. I scratched my head putting my duffel bag over my head at the airport.
No way. That badly?
Yeah.
Was the plastic adjuster
broken?
It was
my nail.
Your nail?
Yeah, like I was throwing the strap over my head and I got myself with the nail. So
when you get that old, it's about your skin gets thin.
That's you know, yeah,
the
right?
Liver spots kind of making it easy.
I think you need to like say like, you know, you crashed and the mountain bike visor snapped and cut your head.
Yeah, I got to come up with a better story for sure.
How's airplane life? Model airplane.
It's good. I got a simulator now, so I'm practicing at home.
Oh, shit. You have like the goggles?
No. I just use the same controller. And so now I'm not wasting money every time I crash. You just hit the reset button.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So are we riding Blue Bug Wednesday?
Let's do it.
Okay. Look at you.
Okay. Good evening.
How do you rate that statue ass?
Damn.
It's pretty good.
Yeah. I mean, the one on the right's about a solid 9.
She does squats.
0.8. Yeah.
Don't skip squat, though.
That's, yeah. I mean, if I would imagine, or if I could guess, she probably is in the Olympics. The one on the left, I wish I had.
You wish you had that man's ass?
I wish I had that man's ass. I need to do a couple more squats.
Did you see how big his dick is in the front?
It's not,
there's no scars on it either.
Dude, that thing is, yeah. Huh? I mean, that's a clean one. I mean, I'd be lying if I said I wouldn't trade.
Oh, all right, so we're at Supermotocross Press.
Oh, yeah.
What do you know about Supermotocross?
Supermotocross. I'm not sure. I know. I've heard of Supermoto before, but never heard of Supermotocross. Nah, I know we got three more rounds after the season, and you know, it's where the big boys show up, they say.
Are you excited about that, to race instead of having off time?
You know, I if I would have done it, you know, I would have done it a little different, but hey.
Yeah.
It is what it is. We're getting, you
it's
know,
it's all part of the job, right?
This purse is going to be a big time game changer, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And, racing in LA and then I'm not sure where else, but I think it's going to be exciting.
Yeah. Have you ever raced here at the Coliseum?
No, I've never even been to the Coliseum.
Oh, really?
So this is my first time seeing these asses.
Did you see? See all the homeless people outside and the crackheads and the tents?
Oh, yeah. There's about a line
of
trash.
You raced Dodger Stadium, though, right?
No. I don't think, right?
Yeah, I think so when you're on 250.
No, I went to
Oh, look at this guy.
I went to Santa Clara.
Look at this guy.
Yeah. What's up, buddy?
What's up?
You look good. The walk by
hair. You look good.
She like, oh, we need some.
Mr. OTW here. Are you still on the program?
No.
No, you're off? No,
we're actually
you look good.
The pit bike of nations.
He's the world champion, right?
This is world champ right here.
World champ.
That's right.
Did you know he's also an e-bike maven? Like distributes and sells zero twos?
Zero two. Bar hoppers.
Cruisers.
I'm in the market.
Huh?
So let's go.
Yeah. He'll give you a discount.
Yeah, the friend discount.
Go.
Have you eaten Korean food yet?
No, I haven't.
Dude, we're going.
Where are we going?
We have
you keep
to go.
On saying we're going.
No, no. Dude, so I've been to the one I was telling you about off 79 South.
Uh-huh.
It is so good.
Let's go.
I went two more times.
I'm waiting, dude.
We're going. Okay, how about...
No, you fell in love in Singapore. That's all you ate the whole time we were there was Korean food, remember?
Yeah, dude, it's good.
What's the difference? Like, what's different from Korean and Chinese food?
Bro.
Spicy?
Chinese is whole fried rice and sweet south pole. No. The Korean food's sick because it's all spicy. You like spice, right?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah. Okay, we're going. This week?
No, so like wait. Thai food or no?
Smokes Thai food. You know, Thai food is all like coconutty and curries and stuff. Korean food's different.
All right. We'll try that.
We'll go. Is your mom in town?
No, she's not.
She's never had it either. I was talking to her.
Yeah,
Salt
Lake. She's never had it. But
Korean lady never had
it. Maybe we gotta wait till she comes into town. We'll go.
Yeah, I don't know. Now, I guarantee you're gonna be hooked.
All right.
Take you. You're gonna like it. So, I think my week is screwed, but let's do it next week.
Yeah.
Are you riding yet?
No, I just started training, but I'm gonna do like a 2-week boot camp and then start riding. I think we're getting our new bikes in somewhat soon, so.
You're not supposed to say that. You're supposed to deny that there's a new gas chassis coming.
Supposed to deny it?
Yeah.
All right, there's no new bike, so we're just waiting.
I asked Ollie about it last week. He goes, what new bike?
Yeah.
So, how big did you go in Hawaii for the Heart Wrap wedding?
Oh, I went big. Dude, I had a big off season. I went to Cabo with like some of the homies, and then I went to Hawaii for Brandon's wedding. It was a good time.
Yeah, good times?
It was a good time. Yeah, I got back Friday, had a fitness test Monday, which was yesterday. Just died, dude.
Yeah, so what kind of things that to do a fitness test right after vacation?
I know,
right?
Yeah, literally.
Although I guess that's good because they make you look like a stud when you get in shape, right?
Yeah, true.
But really though, how much can a guy like you get out of shape?
Dude, you'll be surprised.
Really?
I lost a lot.
Really?
I lost a lot in the past month.
A lot of cardio?
Yeah, just cardio. Some upper body and like just strength stuff, but you lose a lot of cardio. Like a couple, I think 3 weeks is like when you lose, or you start losing everything. Yeah. But yeah, we're just on the mend to getting it back right now. Dude, I went to the gym this morning, went straight from the gym here, and I'm freaking hurting.
Right now,
I'm hurting. I'm crippled.
What do you know about super motocross?
To be honest, I don't know anything.
Yeah. That's why we're all here, huh?
That's why we're all here.
Find out.
Yeah.
So you had a busy September.
I did. Went back to Japan.
Yeah, how was that? So you went back to Japan and you raced, from what I'm told, like a stock SR450.
Yeah.
They just added 4 cc's of oil to the fork?
No, well, kind of is, but like the bike was stock, all stock, but me and the Showa guys did a day of testing, so we made the bike a little better.
Also had Showa on.
Because
SR comes with KYB.
I don't know, but we did
you work with Showa?
Okay, testing with them, but so we made the bike a little better. But engine wise, it's stock.
Standard.
Yeah, standard. So,
how was the racing? That was your first MFJ National, right?
Yeah.
That's kind of crazy to think. That was your first one.
Yeah, it was good. I was like, it was right after the season. So, like, the physically, mentally, like, just was like really prepared.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, had a good weekend. Went 1-1. So, no, that was good. That was really fun.
How hard did you try?
Oh,
did
I tried
you go 100%?
Yeah, for sure. Oh, yeah? Every time I go out to the track, it's like, no doubt.
Yeah, was it whole shot lead the whole time, or did you?
No, so first moto, I did get a whole shot and led every lap. I had one pretty good crash in the middle of the race, but still was able to win. In second moto, I was like maybe third, fourth off the start, and I went outside of the track to where the fan is, and then I tried to get back on the track, but I couldn't because there was like a fence that you can't really go in. So I turned around, did a U-turn, started at dead last.
Oh shit!
And yeah, was able to came back to first again, and then I was able to win. So it was fun.
What did Tomita say to you? Cause he's gonna win the title this year, right? I think.
Yeah, I think so. He's looking really strong at the moment. I don't think, honestly, don't know why he would not.
Yeah.
And he's me and him are like really good friends. So
yeah.
He's like, congrats, you're fast.
How was the fans? I mean, Japanese motocross fans obviously follow you here, right?
Yeah. I mean, it was actually really crazy. Yeah, like probably like maybe like 6,000 people came in.
Mm-hmm.
which is like unusual for Japanese national. Yeah. Even like so many people came in, like the parking was full. Mm-hmm. So I went outside of the street to the freeway. Mm-hmm. So the cops show up and stop me. It was kind of a crazy event, actually. Yeah.
Let's see him.
It's already got the rubber one.
Where's yours? Oh shit, dude. You went big. How long did you save for that?
My whole life.
Yeah?
I'm still saving.
Yours looks like a rubber ring.
Yeah, mine's like, I think, $15 for a pack of six on Amazon.
His real one.
Is that what you bought him? Or is there a real ceremonial?
There's a real one. No,
my real one's sick, but so I got it sized like mid-season, and then our wedding was 3 weeks after the season, and
that was a little tight.
Yeah, it doesn't fit yet. So I start riding next week, and give me a week.
Yeah,
a week of riding and like a couple weeks of training, it'll fit fine.
What is your strategy for the ring at the track?
This.
That one.
Oh, so you'll wear that to the track?
You'll probably...
Because you can ride in that.
You'll probably never see me in my other one.
Okay.
Yeah, it's pretty flashy for me. It's like, I mean, it's all gold. And then, like, on the ends, it's like, kind of got little tiny diamonds and stuff.
Oh, it's more of diamonds?
Yeah. Hmm. Clearly, she was a little bit helpful in picking that up.
Yeah. I want to say I've lost 3 wedding rings.
Really?
Just because at the track, you know, you take it off and you stick it in your shoe or something.
I'll probably just run a rubber one. Like, yeah. I just...
Well, you gotta wear the rubber one because you can't ride in the ring. Yeah.
We do stuff that you can't wear a metal ring.
I have a buddy that got hit in the finger with a rock and it swelled up and he had his ring on. The paramedics had to cut it off with a big bolt cutter.
Dude, that's gnarly.
So, well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Is everybody asking, like, when's a kid?
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
Oh, dude, that started, I felt like, right after we got engaged, but...
Just practicing.
Yeah. Now we're super allowed to practice, right?
Yeah. Oh, finally.
No, we got some time. Yeah. We got some personal goals before then, you know?
Hey, what do you know about super motocross?
It's super. Know, like, I think I feel like I know what's... The deal, right? Like,
yeah,
it's sick. I'm stoked for it. Like, yeah. I think it's gonna be sweet for us. Like, I think there's a lot of upside for the riders, which is nice. So,
I'll learn. Off season.
Yeah, pretty big too, huh? Yeah. Like, it goes till the mid October.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know. It's kind of like one of those things where I guess. I feel like everyone takes a 2-ish week break anyway.
Uh-huh.
So like our 2-week break is gonna be pushback. Like, you know.
All right, congrats again.
Thank you.
We're at the LA Coliseum and Jeff Stanton is here.
What's up, man?
How are you?
Good to see you.
What's up?
Can you do it for me?
How are you?
Can you do it for me? Reenact it for me? No, it was more aggressive than that. Come on.
I'm holding on. Number one.
So you have good memories of this place.
Absolutely. Yeah. When I walked in yesterday, it's like, great place. Fun vibe. It was obviously a great night in the history of motocross and supercross.
I think that's one of the most iconic camera shots ever.
Absolutely.
Was the number
and so,
one.
We went to dinner last night and I was telling stories about the whole thing and just how the whole day played out. And so, it's awesome. It's an honor to be here.
Yeah.
And, you know, some 30 years later and be a part of what's happening today with, you know, the supercross and motocross combo, and so I'm pumped.
So are you going to be called up and interviewed today?
Nice. So you know, over the last 30 years, each year if you add up supercross points and outdoor points, obviously we know who's number one on that list. Ricky's got 5 and I've got 3 and Villapoto's got 2 and so they got us going up, and it's all
nice. Is Bailey coming? Because remember they had the Grand National Championship plate.
I don't believe Bailey is coming. No. And so, fun times. I think it's going to be great for the sport. Supercross and motocross coming together, working together.
Yeah.
And I guess most importantly, the streaming package and the TV package is going to be outstanding. And then, listen, we're going to have a playoff.
Yeah.
Every sport has a playoff, and so it's all good.
Dude, I'm so pumped the news is out.
Finally, right? Huh? It's probably the worst kept secret of the year. Like, I mean, 90% of the people knew it,
yeah.
But obviously I couldn't say anything respect to the team and obviously contract, but yeah, today's an official day.
It's kind of a weird day, October 3rd.
October 1st was, so yeah. Fox came out on that. It was on the weekend though, so
uh-huh.
I rode the bike yesterday for the first time. It's pretty cool. It's kind of like everything at once. Like,
yeah.
New gear deal, new team, new mechanic, new practice guy. So everything you kind of get thrown at once, but luckily I've kind of been building a relationship with these guys throughout the past few months. So mm-hmm. It hasn't been like I've been thrown into it, you know, so it's cool. It's different. Like when I put this yellow and black shirt on, it's like, it's going to take a few days to get used to.
Hey, you know what's cool about you is that you care about things. Like, you're not just after the dollar,
yeah.
You know? Because, like, dude, as long as we've been hanging out, you've had other sponsors and stuff, but I know you've always thought Fox was sick, right?
Yeah.
So when it came time to get your own gear contract, you know, regardless of a team contract or whatever, I knew you were going to go Fox, right? And it's funny because our buddy at Fox kind of screwed with us and said, we lost him the fly. And that's why I texted you. Dude, really? But he was just jacking with us, you know?
Yeah, so, like, at first, when I heard that they called my manager, mentor, Connor, I'm like, that's bullshit. They didn't call. Like, why would Fox want me? They got Adam, Ken, like, they're the best. Why would they want me? And so at first I was like, no way. And then it all started becoming more and more real. I went and had a meeting with them, and obviously I wore Shift with Geico, and then I wore Fox for like two races before I tore my ACL with Honda. And every time I go to hang out at the HQ or see any of those guys, it always felt so like normal and like just like felt like home. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, I don't care. Like, yes, money is obviously huge and I have a family to support, but we make this work. I want to go Fox. So, I mean, I probably could have went somewhere else for more money, but it wasn't the end all be all for me. It was all about like being home and having that, like, you know, I look good. I'm going to look good all the time.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I don't have to worry about that. And no, like, no hate on other gear companies. Like, I enjoyed being in Thor and all the other ones I wore, but Fox is, I feel like, you know, in my mind, high up there. So I'm excited to be part of it.
Yeah. First day on the bike.
Yeah, day one.
Yeah, what was
we rode Kuya yesterday. Talon Hawkins came out and rode with me a little bit. And I swear by lap two, I felt at home. So it was a little stressful because I've never rode an Austrian bike, and people are like, oh, you rode it when you signed, you know, during Supercross. And I'm like, I didn't, you know, like, I swear, like, I looked at pictures and that's about it. So I talked to a couple guys and yeah, a little stressful, but I felt good. It was exciting. It was cool. Rode a little bit of motos here and there, just outdoor, and then I'll go to Supercross tomorrow. Ride a couple days of Supercross out here and just keep flying back and forth from Florida to here. I'm training with Alden now, so yeah, it's been exciting. A lot of stuff. We moved from Tallahassee to Claremont. Kids are starting school. It's like I said, a lot of moving pieces, but it's like, it's all really exciting. It's fun and chaotic in the Craig house right now, but fun.
Do you ever feel sorry for Jagger getting pulled from school to school? I mean, the kid probably makes friends instantly.
Yeah, yeah. I feel like they're at the age where it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
But I do want him to be at a school where he's going to have that friend for life, you know? So hopefully, you know, this is a 2-year deal and we're going to be there for a while. And we love Claremont, and we can see us raising our family there. So, yeah, you never know, but I'm excited. You know, we're enjoying this. We're like enjoying every step, like from the Fox video that came out on Saturday to today to this whole announcement here. I mean, exciting days, but there's gonna be a lot of hard work coming too. I know with Alden and a lot of testing, so it's gonna be fun.
Congratulations on everything, dude.
Thanks.
Well, hey, congrats.
Thanks.
I heard some news.
Oh, what's the news? Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Is it
April,
secret?
April. No, it's not a secret.
It's not a secret. Okay.
No, but yeah, April, I'm going to have a little Anderson rolling around. So it's cool.
All right.
Yeah. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I heard the news.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Exciting.
Big news?
Big news.
What's more exciting, World Supercross news or baby news?
This is Baby Super Motocross. Baby. Super Motocross.
Super Motocross. No. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, I was trying to like take it all in. It's a lot. Yeah. I was like, you know me.
So what's the due date? April?
April, yeah, beginning of April. So yeah, he's so excited and I couldn't be happier. It's, yeah? It's awesome.
What,
yeah,
kind of daddy is Jason gonna be?
I think he's actually really like, he has a really soft heart, so I think he'll be an awesome dad. I think if we have a girl, we'll find out in a couple of days, he'll be a great girl dad.
You guys are gonna cheat.
Yeah.
See, I was old school. I didn't,
yeah,
wait,
you waited. Oh, well, yeah. I like outfits. I like to pre-plan.
I kind of knew it was coming. Like,
yeah.
Two daughters is like divine payback for my college
years. That's what my mom said. She goes, you're gonna have twin girls one day for all the people you put me through, so.
Congrats. Yeah.
Thank you.
You're ditching out of our carpool?
Yeah, I kind of want to go home.
Yeah, you didn't know you had to come with guys that had to work, huh? So,
you gotta get ready for tomorrow, right?
Hey, so this World Super Motocross Championship, right? You're Supercross.
Say it again, I didn't understand.
Super Motocross,
okay, got it.
Champion, World Championship. Realistically, though, if you have a great Supercross season, even though you're not doing motocross, you'll be in the top 30 points wise, right?
I think I have to ask them again.
I think so.
No, yeah, I think so. Yeah, yeah, because I only have a like Supercross deal, so I'm not like pretty sure I'm not racing outdoors. You know what I'm saying? So.
But if you win a Supercross, you're automatically in.
Even if I don't, right?
Yeah, even if you're not.
I can just go and then do like a LCQ, they call it.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, you're in.
We'll find out.
You're in.
Yeah, we'll find out.
Three races at the end of the year. What are your thoughts about it?
I think I'm more excited to see the whole Supercross and Motocross getting together.
Working together.
Yeah, working together. I really believe that also the infrastructure of outdoors, I mean, I'm hoping, I have no idea, but I'm hoping it will look better, like, you know, MXGP,
yeah,
like, you know, we went to Motocross of Nation, you saw the podium,
you saw the
pit lanes,
yeah.
Yeah. I want to see that here, like, that was the biggest difference, you know, moving from, you know, Europe to here. Like, you knew the podiums, like, podiums are, like, we're sitting, like, next to each other. Like, there was no, like, one, two, and then three.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, little things like this. We can probably, they can make it better like that. And plus those three races with big prize money and stuff, it's huge for the riders and also the TV coverage and Peacock for the whole season, like a whole year.
No, nightmares.
This is
like
huge. This is huge.
Like this summer's coverage is bad.
Yes, honestly, and I feel sorry, but I always heard complaints about first moto on one channel and then second moto on another channel. Like, people don't have both channels and they can't follow the. So right now, if everything is on Peacock, you get one coverage, and then you, or even on TV or whatever, but the Peacock, you can see everything.
Yeah.
That's huge.
Last question. They're saying hybrid track, right? So do you run Supercross suspension or?
I don't like when they say that.
Hybrid.
I mean, no. I don't know. I mean, yes, the Monster Cup was always kind of hybrid, right?
No whoops.
But we always, no whoops. No whoops, but you have like real rhythm sections, Supercross rhythm sections. So you have basically have to run Supercross settings.
Yeah.
And then you just figure out how you go through the sand rollers when they get rough.
All right, you guys. Everyone is beating you to the punch and getting married. When's your date? You haven't said a date yet?
Did you sketch it? You said it? It's kind of her deal, okay? I'm just here.
All right, so we're at this Super Motocross World Championship press conference right now. What are your thoughts about another series added onto your schedule?
I think the biggest thing for me that I think is good is the TV schedule. I think that everything being on one TV program, I think is like the biggest plus of the whole thing, just because I know that that's been the biggest, I guess, issue with even a little bit Supercross, like the whole transition from like NBC Sports and then kind of to Peacock, and then kind of I feel like was even a little bit of a cluster in that to watch it, and now obviously outdoors was definitely not good to watch on outdoors. So I think the biggest plus is that it's all one one place, one package, one everything to watch it there, and I think that's going to make people watching it a lot just easier. And obviously the purse money for the last three rounds is a huge deal. I think they said that they were increasing the purse money throughout the whole year.
Yeah, 1.1 million to each
throughout
series.
The whole year. Yeah. Oh, to each series.
Yeah.
So that's good. So that's good just in that, but then also the whole thing at the end of the year, the whole last three races thing. That's awesome. Just anytime, I mean, as a rider, anytime that we hear we're going to be making more money, it's obviously, yeah, we're all in. We're all for that. So, yeah, I think it's good. Hopefully the more playoff style of things can get more people involved. If that's, I mean, I know obviously all the stick and ball sports are like that. So if that is something that will help motocross grow as a sport, motocross, supercross grow as a sport, then that's awesome.
LB. LA Memorial Coliseum. Two things I think of are Jeff Stanton doing his like at the camera, and then you fucking flying down the peristyle with your arms and legs just everywhere.
Yeah.
Is that the first thing you think of when you think
I
of this
do.
Place?
Every time. I walked here and walked straight in there and looked at that pillar that I hit and then looked down the edge to see how far I fell. Because obviously it was way steeper and way further because it was 20, 30 years ago.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was still pretty far down there.
Was that a supercross or an ultracross?
Ultracross.
So you had a pink ribbon streaming from your back.
I did. And that was the problem because they had driven the cars. They go backwards or they go forward on the course and then we go backwards. And a car had hit one of the hay bales and knocked it out.
Oh, that's why you did that.
That's what I hit. So I didn't hit the pillar. I just caught the hay bale at the end and it ripped the bars out of my hand.
So you're like forever NBC Sports highlight reel, right?
Exactly.
Did you get hurt in that crash?
Kind of dinged me my brain a little bit, but split my eye. Nothing major.
Did you split your eye because of your glasses inside your goggles?
No, it's because my head slapped the ground on about 100 miles an hour.
You were an OTG goggle wearer forever, right?
Oh, yeah.
You always raced your glasses inside?
Yep. I didn't get my eyes fixed until I was done racing. I was too scared.
Did you get LASIK?
I did.
Dude, one of my buddies at the bike shop was going to get this crazy surgery where they insert a contact in your eye.
Oh,
have
I
you
know
heard
that.
Of that?
I know of that, yeah.
Sketchy.
My brother had that done. And
really?
It got infected. Yeah.
Yeah, no good.
Yeah,
no
bad good. Deal. Bad deal.
D-Pipes, thoughts about world, no, not world, Super Motocross World Championship as a team owner?
I think for us it's a good deal because for us and like our partnerships, it's easier to sell it as one package, right? So with kind of what we're doing and like the deals that we have had to do in years past, right, we have to sell it as, hey, we're doing SX and motocross. People are always like, well, why are you doing both? And then you kind of have to like explain to them that, hey, this sport is like one big package. The riders do this, this, and this. And now it's going to be a lot easier when we have those partnerships and when we try to do these different activations and stuff like that from a team standpoint, you know, to put that in a nice, crisp box, right? So that's the advantage that I see to it.
Okay, so you've had success as a team owner wrangling up two of the industry's biggest outside sponsors.
Yep.
So you obviously have experience in promoting the sport to a non-endemic sponsor, advertiser, or whatever. But so you think this will make it easier then, right?
Yeah. No, it definitely will because you gotta realize that a lot of people at these companies, they're not in it like we are. Like we're passionate. We breathe motocross, right? We breathe SX. So like we know that the riders are gonna do supercross and motocross. These guys don't know shit about it. They just see the audience, the numbers, how we can help them affect their business, right? So, you know, to put it in one package and to be able to explain it easier to them is gonna be, I hope and I think that it'll help, you know, propel the sport, you know, further on into the future for all teams.
Cool. All right, does Dustin Pipes Racing leave for a Cardiff pretty soon?
Like, probably leaving here in like an hour to the airport, yeah.
Are you pretty excited about that?
Yeah, so we're in a very, I'd say, advantageous position. So, you know, luckily, you know, we have great partners in Feld where we're here with, and we have great partners with the World SX2, and it's a new venture that we're very excited to be a part of. They're very... very organized and they kind of know what they're doing. So I think it's exciting, you know, what's going on around the world in the sport of motocross. And I think it's, you know, exciting times to be involved in it and exciting times for fans, because there's a lot of opportunities for racers and for a race team to be involved in both. It gives us some added flexibility. So let's see.
This announcement of this new series, is it tempting to bust out the 181 again and come out of retirement?
No, I'm too fat.
Are you giving me more gifts?
Yes.
So let me ask you, what do you think of the Super Motocross World Championship?
I can't comment on that. I'm so sorry.
You can't comment? Why not? No, are you confidentiality agreement?
No, I just, it's
no opinion?
My job. No.
Have a nice
sorry
day.
Sorry about that.
Okay, Snow Summit, closing weekend, Friday. I don't know why they have to close. It doesn't look like it's about to snow anytime soon.
Probably not.
For skiers. All you pinkies out snow sport people, ruining our summer and cutting it short. Right? I don't know. I guess they have to put that guy said they have to put the snowmakers in position.
So they'll do the man-made, even if it doesn't snow.
And they have to get the latte makers and the hot chocolate machines ready, right?
Yeah.
For all these snow bunnies.
Yeah.
Weenies.
Wendy.
Carp. So closing weekend, everybody wants to get it in while they can. The lines are crazy today.